Hello and welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be doing another kit up video. I really enjoyed filming my last one. So I've got my trays and I am going to be kitting up this chicken diamond painting, the one that I got recently in a Temu haul that I showed. So what I'm going to do is just go ahead and do that. I wasn't going to film this today or yet, but I felt like the urge to film to take my mind off things and stuff like that. So as you can see, these are all the symbols. So some of these are going to be quite interesting to do. So I'm just working this out. So number 3, for instance. So they are showing here, if you can see, like number 3, number 2, all the numbers with like, all the letters with like a circle around. But when you actually have a look here on the actual painting, let's think, for instance, A. A is this bit. Obviously, they are circle drills, but they're not actually like got a picture of a circle. So I think I can just go ahead and just do it as like numbers and letters. Even I think the ones that are special shaped drills, like down here, these kind of eye shaped ones, these I don't need to draw the eye shape, like I'll be able to tell by the drills, I think. Or will I? Have they done something wrong here? No, so this is weird. So this eye shape one I thought was an M, it's actually an E. It's just the way it is on the table, which kind of makes sense because the G and the H and the J are sideways. So yeah, I'm not going to bother doing the whole symbols. I'm just going to write the letters or numbers. So I've got some of my stickers. I'm going to go ahead and do this first. It feels forever since I filmed the video because I've kind of pre-filmed loads. So this pen, is it not going to work? There we go. So yeah, I'm filming this today. I'm going to be doing at the end of this month, this should be up beforehand, I don't really know what I'm going to do because at the moment I haven't completed many colouring pages. If I complete enough, I will do a completed colouring pages. If not, what my plan is I'm going to do a completed diamond painting. But it's going to be like diamond paintings I've completed since I last made one of these videos, which was like months ago now. So there's quite a few different diamond paintings I want to show you that I've completed. So I might do that depending on how many colouring pages. I might just do both, but in like separate videos. And then going forward, so I'm just concentrating on this. Going forward, I am going to be going back to what I did very, very originally, which is where I'm going to include anything I've completed that month, like diamond painting, colouring, different things like that. I'm going to all include in one video at the end of the month. It's going to be easier. But yeah, I've been focusing so much on a diamond painting this month that I completed that I actually haven't done much colouring. I've completed 1.5 pages so far, and we're in the middle of the month, so we've still got time, but we will see. But surely once I kit this up, I think I'm going to want to get started on this. So I'm going to start with this tray here. Stick these on. I think these are the same trays I used in my last kit up video. Since then I've completed that painting, so yeah, that's exciting. Again, I will have to show you in a completed video, because there's a few to show you. It's quite cold today. Like, suddenly in the UK, the weather has just changed. The past few days it's been cold, but then it's meant to get warmer again, which I'm really wanting this cold weather to just stay. I love the cold. It's a little bit annoying inside because, like, I don't want to have to put the heating on, but then outside I like it when it's cold because I can just wear a coat and keep warm that way. So I've been quite busy recently, doing stuff. Well, I say doing stuff, I've been like normal day-to-day stuff. I joined the gym, which, for those that, obviously a lot of people don't know me, like, I hate exercise, I hate anything like that, but I decided to join the gym just for like my fitness and stuff. I just thought it would be a good idea, and to be honest, I've been loving it. Like, I've been going quite a bit, so I've been doing that. Next month is my birthday, so that is exciting. I can't wait for that. I might be going away as well, which is exciting, but also I'm quite nervous about. Basically my passport had expired, and my partner didn't have a passport, so he got a passport and I've renewed mine. And then we're thinking of going to Paris, but I'm really nervous because we haven't got long. We need to get booking it if we want to do it, but I'm really nervous because I haven't been abroad for over 10 years. And last time I went abroad, I was a teenager or something, and I was going with my family. So they obviously organised the whole trip and everything we did. And they kind of like, it was Spain, I think I went to. They obviously, like, if we went anywhere, they spoke and they directed, like, they knew where to go and stuff. And, like, we've got to do all that by ourselves. And it's, like, neither of us have been to Paris. I've been to Disneyland Paris when I was a child, but I've never been to Paris. And I only know very basic French. So it's going to be a bit scary, but yeah, somewhere I've always really wanted to go. We wanted to go to Italy, but the problem is obviously to go to Italy you have to take an aeroplane. I don't really like aeroplanes, and the fact of going on an aeroplane just kind of scares me a bit. Plus also getting to the airport, the flights, all the different travel involved actually will end up costing more. So we are going to be going on, if we go, we'll go on the Eurostar, because we can get to London quite easily and take that, and it's also quicker to get there. So it will be exciting, but it'll also be nerve-wracking. We're only going to go for a couple of days during my birthday, most of my birthday, just be nice to like try some French foods and visit the Eiffel Tower, all that type of stuff. So yeah, see if I can get any French diamond paintings, which I don't think I'll be able to, but you never know. I actually went shopping in London the other day, and I went to Westfield in Stratford, and yeah, that was exciting. Because I have been there before, but not for a long, long time. And I went to, last time I went shopping in London, at the start of the year, I went to Oxford Street, and I didn't really enjoy it. Like, it's okay, but the problem is the shops aren't the same anymore. A lot of them have shut down. But we went to Westfield in Stratford, it's so much better. The shops are, and there's a lot more shops that are open. I'm just gonna start doing this now. So I can't remember what I picked up. Oh, I had to get some trainers, which is fine, whatever. And then I went to, well, the most exciting thing was I went to the workshop there, and they had it's quite like a big workshop compared to the one near where I live. And I picked up a colouring book that I wanted, which I was so happy to find. There will be a flip through on my channel coming up for it, so do check that out. It'll probably be next week, I think. Maybe, depends when this gets uploaded, but yeah, it was good, because this colouring book that I picked up, I wanted, well, I seen it in my local workshop and was umming and ahhing about it. And by the time I decided that I wanted it, they stopped selling it. So I was so happy to find it, because it's more expensive on Amazon, I believe. So I picked that up. I did have a quick look at their diamond paintings, but I'm not going to lie, their selection of diamond paintings was quite poor. And then I went into, they've got an art shop there called Cass Art. Now, I think it's closing down, because it said something like end of lease sale or something along those lines. And having a look, pretty much like the shelves were empty. There was like not much stuff left, and there was nothing really I wanted, so I didn't buy anything in there. But it was a nice, like really, really nice store. I would recommend, if you want to go to like London and do some shopping, like proper shopping, I'd go to Westfield over Oxford Street. I think Oxford Street's a bit overrated. I find a lot of the shops that were good there have shut down. And I'm not going to lie, there are some good shops there. But I just feel like it's a lot of American sweet shops and touristy places. I also prefer the Primark in Westfield. So when I went back into London in February, I went to Primark on Tottenham Court Road, and it is massive. The one in Westfield is quite big, but I find it a lot more manageable. So yeah, I'd love to go to the Primark in Birmingham, because apparently I think it's the world's biggest Primark or something like that. But I've seen videos of it, and it just, I don't know, something about it just puts me off. The fact that it's too big, it's going to be just, yeah, I don't like places that are too big. It's too overwhelming, but yeah. I also picked up the other day in Lidl, another craft project that I want to have a go at. So I was in Lidl because they kind of were a bit misleading. So basically, I saw a YouTube video and someone said there was a 50% off sale in the middle aisle of Lidl. So I got excited. So I looked at their website, and yes, it said that this, whatever week it was, there was 50% off the middle aisle of Lidl. So I was like, I need to go. So I went to Lidl. Turns out that not everything was 50% off. It was selected items. Now, they did a similar sale last year. Just under a year ago, I would say. And that was 50% off everything in the middle aisle of Lidl. So that's what I assumed that this sale was, because that's how it was last time. It didn't specifically state in store, and the posters just said 50% off the middle aisle. It didn't state that it was only on selected lines. So I took a ton of stuff to my basket, to the till, and found out that it wasn't 50% off everything, and I was really gutted. Having further inspection on their website, it does state it in small print somewhere, but it's not obvious. I find it quite misleading. But anyway, when I was in there, I did see some diamond paintings, but the ones they have, I think they have like two different designs I saw. I think it was a dragon or maybe dinosaur, and then like a unicorn, but they looked very, very kid type ones, the designs did. And I don't know what the price was, but I just didn't really want them. However, I did find a... I did find a scratch art book, which I have picked up. I haven't like shown it as a haul or anything on my channel because it is literally just one item. But in fact, what I'm gonna do is just see if I can get it now quickly to show you. I'll just see if I can quickly grab it. So this is the book. It's a scratch art Disney one. So it actually comes with the scratch pages, but also colouring pages. And these are what some of the designs look like. Anyway, I had a go at one and I am enjoying it. It's actually a lot harder. So you scratch off the lines and then obviously it reveals a colour. And I have had a go at something similar before in the past, I think when I was younger. So this is a bit different. It is quite fun and relaxing. The only issue is it's quite difficult because the lines you've got to scratch are very, very small. But I don't know if it's geared towards kids or adults because it's quite complex. I would say adults, but I'm not sure. And what I like is one side is scratch art. And then underneath it, like on the following, like the other side of the page, is a colouring page as well, which is quite good. So I might do like a video of like me doing some scratch art, because I think I mentioned in videos before, I said I wanted to have a go at doing some scratch art and I've just never got it. But I like that this was in a book, so it's quite thin and small, because I've seen ones that come in like boxes or like almost like they look like folders or hardback books that are a bit bigger, whereas this is obviously a lot smaller, so I feel like it's easier to store. So I might do like a scratch art video at some point, or vary things up for my channel, and if I complete any, I'll show them in my completed pages at the end of the month. To be honest though, like I'm not going to be doing it all the time. I still want to focus my time on diamond painting and colouring because they're my favourite craft things to do. There's so many craft things I want to have a go at. I miss so much scrapbooking. It's just the amount of mess it makes and the amount of storage space you've got to have for scrapbooking. I had like a whole box, like big, rectangle box for scrapbooking and all my supplies. But obviously you get a lot of like paper pads, embellishments, and they just, it took up so much space. And this box, I stored it under my bed, but it was overflowing, like you couldn't fit the lid on, and I don't have space to do that anymore. So I generally think I'm just gonna not do that. I was watching some YouTuber talk about doing collaging, which I've never really done. I think it's similar somewhat to scrapbooking. I think with the scrapbooking that I did, because I didn't scrapbook, I mean, at one point I was scrapbooking pictures, but then I just started scrapbooking random things. And I think it was a little bit similar to collaging, but again, that takes up so much space. So yeah, I need a big house to store all my, well, even if I had a big house to store all my hobbies in, I don't have the time to do all these hobbies. So yeah, we haven't got any big drills yet, so, or any special drills. I don't think this diamond painting is going to take super long for me to do, as obviously there are parts with bigger special drills, but also there are parts that are partial, so I feel like I could probably do this quite quickly. I want to try and complete it by the end of the month, and then I can get it shown in my completed pages. I've got to work out how to film that as well, because any diamond paintings I complete, I just put them on my wall. And obviously I don't really want to go around and take everything off the wall. So when last time I did it, it was quite difficult to keep my camera still. So I'm thinking I'm gonna have to try and see if I can prop my tripod up somewhere to do it. I haven't got a really tall tripod because I don't need that, so. Yeah, that diamond painting that I kitted up in my last video, my last kit up video, I've completed it now, and my god, did it take, it took time. I think it's the biggest diamond painting I've done, probably, maybe. And I like it, but my gosh, was I sick of K, because it has so many K's on it. Yeah, also my light pad, which is underneath it, it's actually broken. I need to dispose of it because the electrical wire, I'm trying to see if I can show you. You can kind of see up here, has actually come out. Now I actually contacted Amazon regarding this because I was not happy. I was like, I purchased this one from Amazon towards the start of the year. I think it was back in February or something. And obviously that's happened, and you know, these, I don't think it was super expensive, but it wasn't cheap, so yeah, I'm not very impressed really. So I did contact Amazon. They wanted me to return it, but I said, well, I can return it, but the problem is the box it came in, I no longer have, so I have no box to return it in. Plus also, I actually don't know if a delivery company are gonna accept this, because when you return stuff, when you send stuff with Royal Mail, when you take it to the post office, they actually, even if you've got a QR code provided by the company, they always ask me what's in the parcel, and I know there's prohibited items. So they might not accept it if it's like got loose wires, it's a bit dangerous to post. So in the end, they just said, oh, you can just keep it or like dispose of it yourself and we'll refund you, which is great. But at the same time, I don't know how I'm going to dispose that. So it's kind of a bit difficult, but I'll find a way to dispose of it. But that means I don't actually have a light pad, a working light pad. So I'm going to have to... Well, I'm going to have a look, because most of the time I'm diamond painting is in the evening. And particularly now that it's getting darker in the evenings, I need a light pad really. So... I'm tempted to just get like, try and find a cheaper one. I'm not getting an art dot one again. So we'll see. I'm thinking, the thing is, I know Temu and stuff sell them, but I don't really want to make another order on Temu at the moment. I've got enough stuff from Temu. So it'd probably be from Amazon, but I'm thinking like a... just a cheap one. But the problem is, I'm a bit skeptical of having cheap electrics. Like, I'm not really sure, so let's see. Might try and hold off till my birthday, because I did hint at my partner that it would be a good birthday present idea is a new diamond painting light pad. But we'll see. But if he does get me one, it would be from my Amazon wish list, because that's where he buys birthday presents for me from. Because well, he sometimes buys stuff in shops, but he doesn't really know half the time what to get me. And obviously he wants to get me stuff that I actually want, so I might just add one to my list and see if I can happen to get it for my birthday. So once I've done this, I'm just going to have to do the washi tape. So these are all the bigger drills. So that's all the drills kitted up. Move these over here. Okay, so let's move the scissors out of the way. All this rubbish. I feel like that's been very used, that piece of wax. I'm gonna put that in the bin. Just gonna pop these in the bin, and then what I'm gonna do is put the washi tape on this. There's another little piece there. Okay, so I'm going to use this washi tape and just put this on now. So I need a drink after this. It's probably nearly lunchtime, to be honest, if feel like this day is going so quick. Has anyone tried the new Coke Zero Oreo? I had it yesterday and wow, it's so nice. It's like really just, I can't even describe how well the flavours go together. I really recommend it. I'm trying to eat sort of healthy and cut out like sugary stuff at the moment. So far it seems to be going quite well, you know. I've not been eating too much sugary stuff, so that is good. Okay, so done this side. I'm just using this black washi tape because this, out of all the washi tapes I own, this seems to be the most stickiest. It's still not perfect, but it's okay. I know I find a lot of my washi tapes do not be sticky enough. And oh, it's not going to be long enough, is it? What's going on here? Oh, I see what you mean. I see what's up on there. Because, yeah, I don't know. I'm trying to remember where I purchased them from. I think the ones that aren't very sticky are from the range. Because I have had them back when I was doing scrapbooking, which I kind of gave up last year. So I think I must have got them at the end of 2022, beginning of 2023. I want to say, yeah, they're not the best. So I keep meaning to get some more tapes, but I can just never decide what tape to get. Cause I did almost get some on Temu the other time of a week, but I need to really stop ordering on Temu. I don't actually rate them anymore. Well, I rate them in terms of their products are good, but I don't actually rate their postage anymore. It's just so long now. I mean, they do give you £4 credit if you're to order as late. So I probably have £4, but then that's gonna pay for like one item, because what, a couple of items, but I've got to spend up to £15 to get delivery. So then I've got to put my own money towards something. So yeah, it's not really. This isn't even long enough. I'm excited because Big Brother is back on next month, which is super exciting. So yeah, I'm excited to watch that. I've seen like a kind of advert on YouTube. It's like just an ITV just advertising that Big Brother's coming back. It doesn't obviously show any of the cast yet, characters. Cast or people going into the contestants going in there, but that will be exciting because this is like the longer one, so I'm excited for that. TV's quite good at the moment. Waterloo Road is back, which is exciting. So they had the first episode on Tuesday, and when I'm filming this, and to be honest, I'm not gonna lie, I've watched it all already. So they upload it all in advance on
iPlayer, so you can literally watch the whole series. So yeah, I've binge watched the whole series. I just couldn't wait, to be honest. I'm wanting to go back and just watch it from series one again, because it's one of my favourite TV shows, always has been, and I want to go and just rewatch everything from series one again. It's going to take time, always does, but I really want to do that. But at the same time, at the moment, I started rewatching the programme This Country, which is like a comedy drama thing on BBC, which again, I've seen before, but I wanted to rewatch. I like rewatching shows. I just find it easy because you don't have to pay full attention to the show. You can just watch it whilst doing something else, and it's good. So yeah. This will do. Oh god, okay. And there we go. So that is this whole painting kitted up. I am so excited to get going with this one. I think in my last kit up I mentioned maybe doing some whipping chats, and I never did, so I can't guarantee that I will do any with this painting, particularly now as it's getting towards the end of the month. I want to just get this one done, but we'll see, maybe. But anyway, yeah, just please like this video, subscribe if you're new to my channel, and I'll see you next time. Bye.